graded stakes racing continues, and this time we go to the Spa, Saratoga, opening weekend, and we have the traditional Grade 3 Sanford Stakes. It did draw a field of 10, and it is going to go as race number 10 on Saturday, all part of a big card that includes the Kelso Stakes and the Diana Stakes for fillies on the turf. But 6 furlongs, 2-year-old colts. You got horses from Steve Asmussen, Dwayne Lucas, and also Ken McPeak. Let's take a look at this 10-horse field. Starting off with the rail, we do got some debut winners in this race. Call the Calvary. One first time out for Ken McPeak. 1 by 2, did take advantage of an inside post position in that race. Irad Ortiz stays on. He was bet down in his debut. He'll be one of the favorites here in the Sanford Stakes. Jive won at Gulfstream Park, a couple of Gulfstream Park shippers shipping in. And this one, a win early one, first crop of St. Patrick's Day out of a Sky Mesa mare. Dickens, a Florida bred, faced Florida restricted horses the first time out, now faces open company, did speed away to an easy win. Edgar Zaya stays aboard. Yo-Yo Candy, Dan Velasquez sends this one out. He won his debut at Parks. We've got 3 different horses shipping in from Parks. Yo-Yo Candy from the speedy son of Dancing Candy, who was a fast horse who was on the Kentucky Derby trail for a while a few years back out of a 2-punch mare. And you don't see that too often anymore. That's another win early indication. Yo-Yo Candy gets blinkers on here for start number 3. Factor You and Me In, another one with blinkers on after a debut win at Parks. That was a 2-furlong race. Those are hard to gauge and kind of judge the talent level of those. Ramming Speed won at Presque Isle Downs, goes synthetic to dirt by Flashback out of Grand Slam. Should be better at sprint distances, and a buyer speed figure 56 in his debut, a little bit slower than some of the other horses. Triple Trey, a Bolt d'Oro first-time starter win off the pace at Woodbine, goes synthetic to dirt. Luis Saez rides. I have a feeling this one could take advantage if there is a speed duel in this race. His rights for Rafael Romero, a win at Parks. That was at 4.5 furlongs, but the buyer speed figure was very low, just a 45. Gold Sweep, the most likely favorite, 1 by 9. The Tremont Stakes for Steve Asmussen. Had a big jump in that second race, went from a 75 to a 91 buyer. And then Market Street won in the slop for Dwayne Lucas, Tyler Gaff Leone, Street Sense. And this one won at Ellis Park in the slop by 3 lengths at 10-1 odds. So that is a look at the 10-horse field for the Grade 3 Sanford. Again, you've got Call the Calvary winning first out. He had the rail the last time. He gets the rail this time. Market Street draws outside. He won on a sloppy track. And then Dickens, a nice winner, ships up from Gulfstream. And then Gold Sweep, the 9-length winner for Steve Asmussen. Top contenders on the betting board. I think Gold Sweep's going to take a lot of play. Market Street for Dwayne Lucas. Call the Calvary with Irad Ortiz and Ken McPeak. Plus the rail, I think he'll take some money. And then Jive, also a chance to take a little bit of money here at Saratoga. It's part of the Pick 5. It's part of the Pick 6. Race 10 on Saturday. Let's go to the replays. First off, you've got Call the Calvary. He won on his debut. What I like about this race is he was inside early. He was third. Now, he did save ground, but he did come just a little bit off the pace. Exploded down the lane, ran perfectly straight, and the first race out goes 5 furlongs from just off the pace. So, Gold Sweep, another one. Fast win at Belmont. This is when I talk about that second start improvement. A lot of times, horses will improve dramatically in either the second start or third start at that stakes level. He went from a 75 to a 91, big win, 9-length margin, drew off for Steve Asmussen. Market Street took advantage of a sloppy win. Again, it's always hard to tell what the talent level is of the sloppy track winners, mainly because just so many horses do not like the slop. So Market Street pulls away early, was on the outside in this race. I like the fact that he draws outside because he was outside horses last time. Ships in from Ellis Park, but those 2-year-old races are strong at Ellis Park for Market Street. And then Dickens, a Florida bred, wins first time out, gets blinkers on here, ships up to open company at Saratoga. but I like the fact that he ran straight, seemed to show some speed. I think he'll be in the mix for Dickens here in the Sanford Stakes. So the pace of the race, again, when these horses are lightly raced, I'm looking more at who's going to run inside, who's definitely going to show some speed. I think Gold Sweep definitely has some speed early. Call the Calvary with that post position may just be sent. And then Triple Trey came a little bit off the pace. I think he'll be comfortable doing that. Market Street may have to settle for coming from that second group from the outside post position for Dwayne Lucas. That's the 4 furlong pace, the way I kind of see it early on. Now, overall, I think we're gonna get a fast pace. I think the race flow is gonna favor those horses on the front end. I think you're gonna see Call the Calvary and Gold Sweep kind of really go after it. Which jockey gets aggressive and wants that lead probably will be the winner of the race. I think that's really where the race dynamic is between Gold Sweep. He's outside of Call the Calvary, but Call the Calvary will be able to save some ground here in the Sanford Stakes. You could go a couple of different ways. I think the 3 Park Shippers are just too slow. I think they will have to improve by 20, 25 points on the buyer speed scale. I like Gold Sweep when running straight. Call the Calvary, I think, can improve. I'm going to stay with the obvious choice here. I went with Gold Sweep. He's going to be the favorite. He was just too impressive. That second start improvement, I think he can run anywhere from an 89 to a 93, and usually that's good enough to win in the Sanford Stakes. I'm going to play him an exactas over Call the Calvary and Market Street. If you're looking for a single, Gold Sweep could be the type of horse to single in the pick 5 or pick 6 Saturday at Saratoga. Don't forget, we've got upcoming previews coming up. Next week, we got the Haskell Stakes. We'll take a look at that full field this weekend. We've got the Whitney on August 5th, the Traverse Stakes at the end of August, the Jerkins, the Personal Ensign, and also from Del Mar, the Pacific Classic, the Del Mar Futurity, and other graded stakes races. As we get to that summer meets, Saratoga and Del Mar, lots of stakes races coming up. We do have a preview of the Schuylerville Stakes for 2-year-old fillies. That's already up. Also, on Friday, we're having an interview with Curtis Stock, the interview of the Turcotts, a very interesting book. 5 jockeys of the Turcotts, all becoming major jockeys. So the Turcotts, make sure to listen for that. And then an early look at the Haskell and Travers, which is next week. Arabian Night pointing for the Haskell, possibility of extra Anejo. So lots of stakes races coming up as we get you ready. The Sanford Stakes on Saturday, Gold Sweep by selection. As Dwayne Lucas says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.